Well, welcome everyone. Thanks for coming today to our session on what's new at CAHRS for 2024. I'm Beth Flynn Ferry, the Executive Director of CAHRS, and with me today is Brad Bell, who's the William J. Connedy Professor of Strategic HR in the ILR School at Cornell, along with the Faculty Director of CAHRS. So we're excited to share with you a couple of new things, new partner benefits this year. So we have all of our old benefits, but several new ones that are just a little bit different. So we felt like we should get some folks together so that we can answer any questions and really share with you what we're up to here. So the three new benefits are CAHRS Learning Series. We're also gonna start producing CAHRS Big Red Books. And we've got a new website, which is pretty user-friendly, more searchable, and I think more pleasing to the eye as you start it. So our intention today is to equip you with the right information to leverage these benefits and also answer any other questions you have. If you do have questions during the session, please just put them in the chat or the Q&A function, and we'll either answer them then or save them for some time at the end where we can spend some more time on those. So with that, we're just gonna dive right in. Brad, you wanna get started with our first new benefit, the learning series?
Sure, great. Thanks, Beth, and welcome everyone. As Beth said, we're really excited to share out some new things that we've been working on. We're continuing to do our working groups, our partner meeting, the webcasts, all the things that you've come to expect from us, but we're really excited to launch some of these new things. And the first one I'm going to talk about is what we've labeled our CAHRS Learning Series. So I want to tell you a little bit about how it came about, and also tell you a little bit about the first topic that we're going to be focusing on this spring and how you can register for it. So, over the last, I'd say, year, maybe 2 years, we've been fielding more and more requests from our CAHRS partners looking specifically for development. And within CAHRS, we've always focused what we refer to as education in terms of our working groups and our webcasts and the research that we put out are all designed to help our partners and the individuals in their functions to educate themselves and to gain new skills and competencies. But what we're hearing from our companies is really more of a desire for really targeted development, which I think reflects just the amount of disruption and change that we've seen in work and HR over the last few years, and the recognition that as a result, we really need to be continuously upskilling and reskilling our HR partners in order to respond to some of those changes. And so, what we've decided to do is really to incorporate more formal development into our portfolio of offerings through, again, what we've labeled the CAHRS Learning Series. Our current thinking is that we're going to offer two learning series per year, one in the spring and one in the fall, that will really focus on critical and cutting edge HR competencies. Our first learning series will be launched this May. It's going to focus on issues surrounding HR analytics and data, focusing specifically on how HR business partners and HR generalists, as opposed to specialists that are already working in HR analytics, can really leverage data to link people data to business outcomes, to apply that data to real life problems and challenges, and to take that data and to think about how they can best make decisions based on it and communicate it out to the leaders that they support. This, as you see on the slide, first series is really geared towards HR professionals that have about 5 to 8 years of experience and again are in more of those HR business partner, HR generalists type roles. It's important to note that each of these series is going to be somewhat different. So we might have future series that maybe focus on more specialist roles or maybe geared towards more senior or even more junior individuals. We really want to make each of these series very targeted to specific audiences so that they can get the most value from them. For this first series, participants will engage in 5 90-minute live virtual sessions, essentially one per week, starting in the first week of May. And during those sessions, they will learn frameworks and tools to really think about, again, how to link people data to business outcomes. They'll also work in groups cutting across our various partner companies on several real life cases that the faculty member leading the series, John HouseConnect, has developed based on projects that he's done with various companies. And that will again provide them an opportunity to apply what they're learning in real time. It'll allow them to build networks and relationships with individuals working in similar roles across our partner companies. And at the end of the program, they'll have a chance to provide out their case solutions and get feedback from John on what they did well and other things that they might think about when doing similar types of projects in the future. I think there's really a few really nice aspects of this series that we'll cut across the various ones that we'll be doing. You know, one is that real-time application. We want to give people the frameworks, the concepts, the principles, but we also really want them to think about and be able to apply that in a practical way. So all these series are going to focus on immediate application through various exercises and case studies. The second one, as I mentioned, is the opportunity to engage with HR professionals from across our different partner companies to learn what their companies are doing, maybe to gain some insight into some various best practices or innovative practices, but to strengthen their network outside of their own organizations. One thing that we've heard a lot working with our partner companies is that these HRBPs in particular often struggle to build those networks outside of the company. A lot of specialists have their own specialist groups that they engage with. You know, if you're a compensation specialist, it might be other groups. It might be for training development, it might be Association for Talent Development, but these HRBPs often don't have those types of forums to go to. So this will be a great opportunity for them to build those networks. This is a free offering for our CAHRS partners. Each company can send one participant. If there's additional space remaining, we're happy to have you send additional people from your organizations. To reserve your spot, we're asking that you please submit your nomination registration by March 19th. That's our priority deadline. There may still be opportunities to nominate someone after that deadline, but what we'll start doing is for those companies that have expressed an interest in sending multiple people, we'll start adding some of those waitlist individuals after March 19th. So to ensure your spot, please do register by March 19th. So we're really excited about this first offering. We look forward to having your individuals participate, gathering feedback from you and them to continue to make this series even more impactful as we launch the next one in the fall. So with that, Beth, maybe we could move on to the next offering, which is our CAHRS Big Red Books. So let me see, I have actually a question that came in. Maybe I'll answer that. Do you have the new cutting edge HR competencies that you can share that you reference? Would be interesting in hearing the latest. Yeah, so we actually did a project through CAHRS a few years back in partnership with our advisory board, co-chaired by myself and Kevin Cox, where we gathered together HR competency models from our various CAHRS companies. We then engaged in an exercise to think about, you know, how those competencies might change over the next several years, which competencies might become more or less important. And we developed kind of competency frameworks for both the kind of HR business partner role, as well as more specialist center of excellence type leader roles. And I think when we send out these slides and materials, we can certainly attach that report for the attendees. So moving on, our second big partner benefit that we're introducing this year is what we're calling our CAHRS Big Red Books. Research has always been at the heart of our CAHRS mission, whether it's the research that our faculty are always doing or the CAHRS-specific projects that we often do in conjunction with some of our graduate research assistants. But again, more and more what we're hearing from our companies is really a desire to help us help them navigate some of today's grand challenges. And we believe that CAHRS is really well positioned to facilitate academic practitioner-led research collaborations that tackle these big challenges and provide our companies with roadmaps that they can use to really move through each of these different areas. So Beth, maybe if you move to the next slide, to get in some of the kind of what we're thinking here, our goal is really to launch our first project this spring as kind of a pilot or test project. And I'll share in a minute what we're thinking about potential topics for that first project, but eventually ramp up to where we're doing three or four of these types of projects per year. Each project will run approximately 9 months and will kind of feed in a lot of the things that we're already doing. So our working groups will be a way to gather insights from all of our various partner companies. Our research assistants that we hire every year through our student population will help to do background research and data collection for these projects. But the goal is really to feed all of these efforts into some larger, more comprehensive projects that really provide deep examinations of some of these key HR challenges. At the end, our goal is to disseminate the insights that emerge through these projects through playbooks, which we've done our own spin on by labeling them the Big Red books. If you're not familiar with Cornell, we're known as the Cornell Big Red. We also will be pushing those out through our website and partner meetings and webinars in terms of some of the key insights. It's important to note, however, that unlike many of the things that we do research-wise that we make available to anyone, whether they're partner members or not, because we believe in advancing the field, the full playbooks are only going to be available to our partner companies. Insights, executive summaries we'll share out more broadly. On the next page, kind of gives you a little bit more information about these Big Red books. Again, really designed to provide a deep dive into the details of how and so what, and to provide pragmatic solutions. So including, recommendations about what might be the implications for your HR operating model, to give you diagnostics and tools that you can use to assess where your company currently stands and what might be the next best steps for you, and a set of kind of short-term, medium-term, and longer-term actions that you might want to start thinking about. We also plan to incorporate short case studies, either that might be built into these books in text form, or maybe will be supplemental videos. But again, we'll provide examples of some innovative and best practices that we're hearing from across our various partner companies. Our goal is by combining making these really a tight collaboration between our academic faculty, but also our partners, is to create playbooks that are rigorously developed, that have a strong research backing, but are also very practical and can be applied immediately within your organizations. We've been working with our advisory board for about a year on this idea. Late last year, we actually surveyed them and their direct reports to ask kind of what types of topics would they want to see in a playbook of this nature. Some that we're drilling down on currently are around things like the employee experience, in particular, generational differences in what employees today are looking for from the employment relationship, how to move towards more of a skill-based organization, how to drive cultural transformation within our organizations, and how to navigate an increasingly polarized world, both within and outside of our workplaces. And so we're exploring these currently and hope to pick one here within the next month or two to get the first one going. So the next steps are to finalize the topic. We're then going to find a couple of our partner companies to really serve as sponsors and then work to start pulling together the data and insights that will feed into these playbooks. So please keep an eye out, because we'll soon be reaching out looking for individuals and companies that are interested in engaging with us in this effort. And we look forward to partnering with you on this exciting new initiative. So with that, Beth, I'll turn it over to you to walk through the new website.
Great. Thank you, Brad. And if anybody does have questions on those items, please feel free to put those in the Q&A in the chat and we will answer them. So I'm going to stop sharing for a minute because I'm going to switch over to our new website, which we're super excited about. It was a team effort, and certainly a long time coming. And Brad, do you see the website? Okay, great. Thank you. And so I want to thank Melissa Burris and Joe Hagan, especially for their work on this with our ILR IT team, but we're super excited about it. And so it's got a lot of the same content that you would have seen in our other website, but it's more searchable. And it's, I think it got a much better look to it at this point. And I'm just going to quickly navigate you through a few things so that you're familiar with it. So our About CAHRS front page here is really just what is CAHRS and what do we offer? And so it's probably more made for companies that aren't partners yet, but are looking to understand our benefits. But it's a good thing to for anybody, you know, within your own company that may be new to the CAHRS experience to talk, to share with them about, you know, what we are. We're an academic institution, but really about partnering with companies, faculty, and students to really advance the world of work, especially in the people front. And we're about connecting, we're about educating, and we're about achieving different things from the business standpoint. And so this front page just explains that and the different offerings under each. You can also go in and click on this to see who our CAHRS partners are. It lists all the companies. Certainly it also has our information in it. If you do the people at CAHRS, it'll have Brad and my contact information, as well as the team. The other, the second most popular area used on our old website was the events tab. And so this is where you go to register. It's where you'll see our upcoming events. And we've got several out here right now. The webcast series is posted. This is one on AI and talent management and how different aspects of our talent functions are dealing with these things. And so we've got a series of these coming up. So you would click on that, you would hit register now. And that's all it is. It's a simple registration. The other thing I do like to share about the events tab is that not only does it have current events, it also has anything we've done in the past. And so if you're looking, for example, for this webcast tomorrow, we'll have the webcast posted on here, the link and the slides that we've used. And so it's out there for your reference at any time. And so, for example, this was a webcast Brad did at the beginning of the year, which was that survey that we talked about before, what issues are top of mind. And you'll have the webcast recording here, as well as a spot to download the slides. Same is true for our working groups, where the working group notes and summaries are located out here. So if you're looking for something in that vein, you should head out to the events tab. If you're just trying to remember what things we have, what benefits and services we have, you would go to that particular tab. And there you'll see all of our different events. So the different events we have, like working groups, and we explain what it is. We have a video and some slides on these. And so the working groups, the roundtable, the partner meeting, benchmarking is also on here, although it's also on our research and insights tab. So that's more information about how you can use us. The research and insights tab is kind of our resource library. And so we have a bunch of resources that that we've gathered and together with your help over time. So we have research briefs, we have the working group summaries, we have the webcasts and the benchmarking all housed here. And if you go to the research resource collection, what you'll see is, you know, this is everything. But if you want to research certain topics, you go into the dropdown. If you're only looking for certain types of things, so you only want student papers, you would click on that. And if you're looking for things, you know, just from 2023, then you could click on that as well. It also has a good search engine function. And so if I Googled searched artificial intelligence and just in general without a year and things like that, you know, you'll see the different things that come up from the research links, the papers, the videos, white papers, et cetera. So it's a really great and easy way for you to search through our website to see what information we might have out there. The other couple things are, you know, many companies, CAHRS companies want to engage with our students. And so this just explains the different activities that we have, again, has videos, et cetera, on that so that you can share those internally if you'd like. We have news as well, which talks to our three forms of electronic news and has our most recent copies out there, but also has things that are happening with our partners or new research that we're doing and sharing with you, et cetera. So that's a good quick way to get something there. And then our professional development page is available to CAHRS members at discounted. It's offerings that are available to CAHRS partners that at a discount. So they're not offered through CAHRS specifically, but these are some of our development programs like the modern CHRO role programs called Top Seat. There's one for chief diversity officers, another strategic HR business partnering program, et cetera. And so you can find out more information and register for these classes there, again, which are discounted for CAHRS members. And the last thing I would point out is under benefits and services, we have an area that has our resources. So again, on the benefits and services, if you're just looking, you know, want a quick look at how to share information internally with your company, we have different things you can download and share here. So CAHRS flashes are, you know, 2 minute or less videos that explain things. So we've got one on what is a working group. We've got a communications calendar so that you can see when things will be coming from CAHRS during the year. And so that's good for your planning purposes. We have an e-news description, for example. And so, you know, what I recommend to our primary contacts is that they share those things out maybe quarterly with your team. So if you have a newsletter or if you have a website, you might want to periodically put these things out there so that it keeps it front of mind for your employees. Because, you know, once you're a member, you're paid for the year and all these things are available. And we want to make sure that you utilize those the best that you can. So that's our website, and hopefully you'll have an easy time finding that. Instead of, you know, our new website address is, let me share this back here again. It's ilr.cornell.edu/CAHRS. So the CAHRS goes at the back end versus the front end. And hopefully you'll love it as much as we do. And with that, you know, welcome any questions you have while we wait to see if we have any of those. I'll just go on to say that we do have our spring calendar is coming together here. So we're pretty excited about it. We've got two different working group series. One is going to be on transformation. So we've got one on HR operating models. We've got a May 16th working group we just posted today on culture and connection. And we're going to also add one on change and org agility. Brad's going to lead some talent development working group sessions as well on skills-based organization, succession planning, and knowledge management. And that talent and technology webcast series that I showed you on the website is already posted out there. Those four sessions are set up as well as a learning series. I also wanted to share the fall signature event date. So we do have the date for the roundtables, exec roundtables in September, and the fall partner meeting in October. Although we don't have those posted yet, they're not available, but mark those on your calendar, get those on folks' calendars in your organization so that you're available to come. And then we'll be sending stuff out to you in our regular events updates on all of these as things get posted. And let's see, something came in the chat here. Let me look. Okay, just somebody thanking us for the session. That's great. Anything else out there? Any questions? If not, then Brad and I just want to say thank you very much for your partnership. We appreciate it. We're excited about these new offerings. And if you have any questions, feedback, et cetera, please just let us know. Have a great week.